How's it going, everybody? My name is Kolosalus. Welcome back to another Heroes of the Storm video. I've been making videos for quite a while, so bear with me if there's any rust showing. But today we'll be taking a look at Ragnaros, which is a character we still haven't taken a look at. Of course, he came out in the period where I was kind of away, not really away from the game, but away from YouTube, you can say. I had a little bit of a break. He is a character who I love by design, but he was hated at the beginning just because people, first of all, did not know how to play against him. Second of all, they did not know how to play against him. And third of all, they did not know how to play against him. Those three things kind of come into one. And also the fact that he was actually strong, but then he was nerfed a couple of times. And I think he is in a little bit of a disadvantaged position right now. And I'm going to explain why once we get into the game. But mainly I wanted to make this video just because I want to make some videos in while I'm making some other nice series for you guys, like Heroes Academy and stuff like that. So without further ado, let's jump in. Alright, boys and girls, we find ourselves on the Towers of Doom here today. He's in a spot where Q build was like the best build ever. Basically was the only thing to do, but I think we're back to the point where I think all three are kind of similar. They all fit different roles. So today we're gonna go for the W build, as they are mostly backline, the enemy team. You can see Lunara, Valyra, Thrall, Probius and Val against Breacher, Sylvanas, Ragnaros, Probius and Valyra. The ability is called Empower Sulfuras. Basically, our next basic attack is gonna happen pretty much straight away, so you can kind of do some nice tricks of, you know, saving a little bit of time, and basically attacking, then straight after the attack, you press Q and you basically refresh the cooldown. You basically do a nice burst of damage, just because Ragnaros does a little bit of nice damage. This Q basically makes it so... it makes it so your next basic attack is gonna attack straight away, and you will also deal empowered damage. It's gonna turn into ability damage. It's gonna be AoE, and it's gonna heal you for 20% of the damage dealt, which obviously is pretty damn strong. So let's get rid of that. Let's just jump into the middle. Deal some damage to those minions. Obviously, Ragnaros is one of the best wave clears in the entire game. I'm gonna give her the movement speed, which is my E ability. My E ability is basically giving movement speed for a little while. And also, at the end of the movement speed, my target is going to explode for damage. Pretty good, pretty good. 25% movement speed for 1.5 seconds, so it's a very, very short burst of speed. But it's always there. It's always there, you know? I don't know what the fuck that was, but... that Valyra just kind of... I don't know. She suicided, I guess? I'll try not to get too bursted by this bro. Probius, by the way, is broken at the moment. I'm gonna be making a video about him really soon. And today we're specking for W build, which is basically this potato that just rolls along. What it does is, you know, it falls down on the ground, deals some damage, and then it also then rolls, also dealing some damage. So, you know, very good for nuking down like backline heroes. It does a ton of damage if somebody doesn't. I know she's somewhere here. I just wanna. I mean, again, I healed for a little bit. Again, I'll be healing for more when I attack heroes, but again, just wasn't enough to sustain through three heroes, and so we're gonna lose all 3 points from that. Good job, team. This ever range, we're gonna go probably for Fire Ward. Again, I guess this team, auto attack, kind of auto attack. So I'm wanting to go catching fire. Let's go catching fire. It's kind of like a little bit like going away from, you know, from just a standard W build, but it's gonna be okay. So again, at level 1 we went for a kind of a stacking talent. We have to hit enemies with our W. When we do, Ooh, is he gonna get the skill? Hope so. Guys? They just left me. I just died. That's why I hate playing quick match. It's so terrible. Like, I went in to help them, I risked my life, and then I paid for it because I helped them, so no more help in this game. Good job, Bolita. Alright, no more dying, and no more saving friendlies in this game. Yeah, so again, it's a questing talent. Basically, you have to hit enemies with your W. After hitting 75 heroes with your living meteor, it's going to be... its duration is going to be increased, so it's going to roll for longer. And also... You can see from that one hit, I got like... I don't know. How many stacks was that, actually? Again, Lunata is so fucking good against me because she can kite me for days. Yeah, and then I think at the end of the quest, what I do... I think I might go into my Molten Core form here. Capture the altars, and this is still the Raven Lord, a grievous blow. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. So Molten Core basically unleashes my full-on form, which allows me to deal damage from with those three abilities. Basically, grab this, God. I basically get a different health bar. Allows me to deal some nice damage from a distance, but also my Q is a huge swing that just stuns enemies. We're able to gain one of those altars at least. That's good. We're gonna go for Molten Power here. Again, you can see why he's just so good at clearing lanes. I need to get the fuck out. They're all missing. Valero is such a good ganker that I should not be risking this. Okay, Lunata's here. Lunata is kind of tricky to go up against, and I think I just saw Valero as well. My Valero is middle, actually. So I'll just wait for the minions. Ragnaros is a great solo laner. Just because of his Q, he's actually an amazing solo laner. Should be fine. Yeah. He's an amazing solo laner just because he can heal off of his Q, and you know, which of course allows him to heal. He can pretty much outdo most of the other solo laners, or at least, you know, if they beat him in lane, he can just wait for the minions and just clear the lane right after. Pretty good. So what we went for on Molten Power. After hitting heroes, next living meteor deals increased damage. So when you hit a hero, you will be dealing more damage with the next meteor, basically. I guess because what we're going for is going to be real nice. It's going to be a really nice burst of damage. Because our friend team just wants to keep dying. That's what they want to do. That's what they're going to do. And also because of our sustain with our Q, we can also do our comps very, very easily. Like, just... like it's nobody's business. We're gonna go for Sulfuras Smash here, finally get to level 10. Level 10, basically, one of the most impactful heroics in the entire game. It kind of does this like area damage in a very, very huge radius around you. This radius, by the way, does get bigger. Does get even bigger when you're in your Molten Core form. But what it allows you to do, just throw down your, by the way, your hammer, and if you hit somebody in this little area around Ragnaros, what you will be able to do is to basically stun them and just deal massive amounts of damage. So I'm just gonna try my best. You can see I did pay my dues to that thrall there. He did kill me, but I did get my Sulfuras Smash up, and that basically killed them off. It does huge bursts of damage, and also stuns the enemy, which obviously any kind of CC is good. So that's pretty much it. Enemies in the center takes again triple the damage. People around just take a little bit of damage. I don't think that's a good engage. Oh, he actually does have a heal, so this should be an easy kill on the enemy Valkyrie. There we go. I'm on my way. Sprobius actually should be dead with one or just my single W right here. By the way, the enemy team still kind of very nice. Yeah, let's go here. Get rid of this. Yeah, give me those stacks. I mean, I'm doing terrible on stacks just because I wasn't in fight at all. But I think we will do it at some point. We need to do this, boys. Like, 100%. I'm gonna try to kind of go around. Okay, there we go. Okay, we have Sylvanas. Friendly team wants to die. That's fine. This game has changed so much since I actually recorded any videos about it. Just actually super exciting. Level 13, we're gonna go for... Do they have stuns? They have stuns from here. Have stuns from here. So I think that's actually enough of the stun. She also went for the stun here. So yeah, so I think we're gonna just go resilient flame here. Which, what it does when you're stunned, it just it grants you a little bit of armor. That you'll be taking less damage. Again, my stacking is not perfect this game. But we will... I'm just trying to poke at him. Nothing, you know, I'm not gonna commit if I don't know if I can kill him. Maybe if we had Butcher next to me, maybe we were able to do something, but we didn't, so I didn't actually commit that much. And honestly, with Ragnaros is knowing when you can commit. It's 100% that. Just go on. Mostly it's gonna be just clearing lanes. Mostly it's gonna be clearing lanes and actually soul laning. What is she? If we can stun her. Thrall's taking tap right now, so we should probably rotate. Gonna rotate. We can definitely kill him here. Definitely. Gonna throw him his mount. Gonna give myself movement speed. And that's gonna be a kill. I don't think we needed it. But again, it's such a low cooldown that... Yeah, we need to go down. We need to go bottom. I probably should be fine just because he can just zone so well. But I think he just fucked himself over by walking through the Vala. And I think now this should keep them off, especially when he actually activated his ultimate now. I want that Vala booty. I didn't get it. Fuck. Let me heal! She's gonna try to get me? Let me go into my Molten Core form here. Start DPSing this Vala down. This will allow me to kind of, get this down a little. You could just see how much damage this is. It's just crazy amounts of damage. We'll be able to kill off this Ding Dong and move on in for the Vala. Vala's trying to DPS us down. I'm gonna let our guy take it. Oh, there we go. Hi. Killing spree. All right, this is gonna give me the armor, which I actually need, and I think I'm gonna be fine. Yeah, I'm gonna be just fine. Actually, I'm gonna be fine. Because this Valyra just killed me. I think I would have survived if I queued her. But I think she just had enough damage with another Invista right there. Are we gonna just keep fighting for this? I mean, I'm fine with that. Right, so at the end, with the level 16 talent is gonna give us a little bit more DPS overall in team fights and just to the enemy backline. It's gonna make our W explode right at the end of its path. So basically, it's a little bit of a counter strategy, but again, like with the redirecting of our W, hopefully once we finish, hopefully we are going to actually finish the quest this game. Once we finish the quest, we'll be able to redirect it, and then at the end of its path, it's gonna explode, dealing some more. Oh, actually, let me go through this. I'll be able to redirect it and also deal a little bit of burst damage. There we go. Very nice burst damage. I don't know what this guy was thinking. Very nice. And we're able. Just like that. Good. Another time. I don't know where the fuck she is. Nice! Very good kill here. I don't know where she is, that Valira. Because if we didn't kill her, I definitely have to go for the Sippy here. And then move straight for the boss with the team. The team wants to start the boss. I am going to do that. Honestly, Butcher is just like prime. Prime boss doer, you can say. Here's Sulfuras. She did vault away. I thought it was a little bit too late on my part. There's going to be a kill on Demon Vala here with charge. And we should be getting all three. I'm not sure if we can get all three. I'm going to start moving down. We should be fine with that, right? I'm just going to start moving down. Fuck it. Alright, looks like Valira is going to take ours, which is just terrible. But we do own one of these altars, therefore it's going to be less shots for the enemy team. I'm going to grab this one, and it looks like we did grab the left-hand side. This lane. Level 20, we are definitely gonna go for submerge here. Submerge is gonna allow us to go into stasis, kind of similar to ice block, but also it is going to allow me to when I'm in the ice block kind of form, it also allows me to regenerate health. It's actually a very sizable chunk of health, so not too shabby. I'm gonna allow us to kind of maybe nullify a lot of damage. Maybe when the enemy Lunara decides to, you know, engage in us with a leap, we can go into submerge, kind of heal off that damage, and also not allow it to tick on us. And potentially, oh, it looks like we are finished with this, so now we can activate it. Put it on one. I did miss that again. God damn it. Alright, so this is on F, this is on 5, I think this is this one. Oh my god. He's dead. I'm taking a little bit more damage now. He's trying his best. There we go. We are able to take down a tower, which should work out well. Then we have just taken all towers. Looks like Probus is moving for the bottom, so I'm gonna try to make this hard for him and not allow him to just take a free. So what I can do here, I can just enter.
Behold, Fapnaros.
I mean, that's fine. There we go, we are able to push out Probus. I know I use my trait for it, but it doesn't really matter, you know. As long as he doesn't take it, and I did soak some damage because it gives me another health bar, a Molten Core. It basically is a win, just because we soak some damage and we did not lose a tower in time. This is gonna be GG. Good game at the end. At the beginning we were kind of feeding, myself included, but at the end we picked it up. We were able to pick up a nice win. Honestly, I missed this. I missed making videos like this, guys. And hopefully you guys are going to be, again, as ready as me to jump into the new era of Heroes of the Storm with 2.0 coming out in just about 10 days. So, let's go over the build again. Again, the build isn't set in stone. You have to look at your team and say, okay, damn, we have three front lines. Okay, we have two warriors and me, which is, you know, kind of three front lines. You're not a real front line, but... So what you do is then the e-build becomes very, very attractive to you, just because you can give you kind of enhance the ability, which gives movement speed and AoE damage around a target, which, you know, if your hero is a frontline and he goes in to the enemy team and just tries to tank damage and stuff, it's going to be really good. When the enemy team has a single warrior but the rest is backline, well, W build becomes super strong. But if you have a single warrior, but and your or even if you have a double warrior, but the enemy team has a very heavy frontline, well, the Q build just becomes super, super powerful. I definitely want to make another video with him, because Q build is just super fun to play with. It allows you to stay alive so much in the fight, just because you will also be getting a cooldown reduction on it. It has a only 4-second cooldown, and then you can cut it into half with some later talents. But today we went for the W build, so that's what we're going to be explaining. So shifting mid tier, I don't think we actually finished the shifting mid tier, but if you do finish it, and if you're better than me at the game, no, we just weren't in fights. Like, you have to be, it's a quick match, so nobody's gonna be worrying about solo laning. I was a little bit so like a solo laner, therefore I didn't actually get stacks just because nobody was up there against me, so I was not able to get stacks. But at the end, we were able to get, at least get close to finishing it, or finishing it. And what it does, allows you to, it increases its duration to 2.25 seconds, and then the ability can be recasted to change the direction. So basically, let's say somebody's trying to dodge it, you just recast it in the same direction they're going, and they're going to be taking some guaranteed damage. Level 4, we did go for catching fire, but of course if the enemy team has a lot of ability damage, like Pyroblast, like Li Ming's combo, and stuff like that, you might as well go for Firewall with any build. Not with just this build, but with any build. But I'm talking about this build just because if the enemy team has a lot of backline, they probably have a lot of mages. In this case, they didn't, so I just went for catching fire. Catching fire, it's kind of a buffed up version of Regeneration Master, in the sense that it gives you a little bit more regeneration for less health, up to 22.5, it used to be 30, but it's now 22.5. After gathering 15 regeneration globes, you are able to activate your catching fire to gain some more armor. So this kind of very nice stacks with your resilient flame, but we're going to talk about that in a second. The other choice here is fire ward, that gives you a spell block whenever you hit somebody with your W. Honestly, very, very good, just because you'll be hitting that shit every single time. Hopefully. On level 7, we did go for a Molten Power. After hitting heroes, next living meteor is going to deal increased damage by 15%. So basically, for every hero hit, increases its damage by 15%. So up to, of course, 75. 15 times 5 is 75. So very, very, not a very heavy, very hard level math right there. But yeah, very, very good, very, very good for your DPS. This is what kind of this build needs and what it actually lacks. So again, this is just gonna give that extra boost to you. Level 10, you want to go for Sulfuras Smash. Level Wave has its uses, especially when countering heavy split push characters like Zagara, Asmodan, Nazebo, stuff like that, mainly, or just any split push overall. It allows you to send a wave down one single lane once every 120 seconds, and basically instantly killing minions, and also dealing heavy damage to heroes and mercenaries. And it doesn't do any damage to structures. Don't be thinking, oh, I'm gonna pick this and just delete structures. No, this is gonna deal no damage to structures at all. Sulfuras Smash, on the other hand, is a very, very good teamfighting heroic, and this is what you're going to be picking up 95% of the time. This allows you to deal heavy damage in the center, a little bit lower damage in the outside area, but also stunning enemies in the center. Very, very good. Honestly, super, super strong. Any kind of... Basically, why this is so good is basically... On your team, if you have somebody like a... Let's say Varian, who has Taunt. Taunt keeps somebody still, so if somebody can hit Taunt and then you hit your R on that person, they're gonna be pretty much deleted, or at least put down very, very low, even if they're attack. So this is a very, very good follow-up ability to any kind of root, stun, Taunt, silence, anything that kind of removes mobility or just puts any character in one place, and just super strong team fighting ability. Level 13, we did go for the Resilient Flame. I do believe this is the only choice, but if the enemy team doesn't have stuns, then you might not as well go for it, just because it's terrible if they don't have stuns. Then I'll probably go for Quieterize Wounds. Then if you're... Empower Sulfuras heals you for an additional 50% of the damage dealt to heroes, which is obviously super good. Very, very good. It gives you a nice heal over time. If you hit like 3 or 4 heroes, you can have like almost half of your health bar, which is pretty goddamn strong. just make sure to hit those money, money cues. On level 16, we did go for Meteor Bomb, leaving explodes at the end of its path. Honestly, at the end, in the end game, this actually is a lot of damage, a lot of burst damage. So again, just try to position your Meteor in a way where you're setting it up to at least blow up minions, but you wanted to put it like in a team fight, where you know it will be exploding somewhere close to you or close to the target you want, you want to kill, basically you want to assassinate. And this is also going to be easier with a level 1 talent, which will allow you to kind of, you know, will redirect it at the end. So maybe let's say somebody is running along it and you just want to make that that final explosion money right at the end, just put it right next to that person who was running next to it, and they're going to be hit by that very, very huge burst damage. And then level 20, we did go for Submerge. Honestly, any ability here is good. So, Flames of Sulfur is probably the worst one at most. Sphere Smash slows enemies 50% for 2 seconds, and enemies in the center are stunned for additional half a second. Nobody ever picks that just because it's so good by itself. So the only two choices I would say here, Lava Surge is okay if you went for Lava Wave, but Heroic Difficulty was the go-to, the only ability you could take, but now after it was nerfed, it's kind of not as good. It is good on maps where you need a lot of Molten Core, so I don't know, maybe like a Cursed Hollow, but I don't know if he's actually good on Cursed Hollow anymore. So again, it just loses value just because you're still gonna have to wait for like 70 seconds for your Molten Core. But I like to go for Submerge. It always gives you some nice regeneration. Again, you're in the front line. Let's say you're getting focused down by a lot of CC, and then once you get out of it, you can just hit Submerge, heal yourself for a very, very huge amount, and also protect yourself from a lot of damage. Let's say, I don't know, there's a Pyroblast coming your way, I don't know, again, Li Ming combo, Chromie combo, you know, with a temporal loop, anything like that, and you're going to be just fine. With, again, and I'm going to just talk a little while about how you're going to play this character. You want to poke a lot. You're a solo laner, so you're supposed to be solo in the lane. You have to know your matchups. Again, the Haka, you should be fine. Against Sonya, you're probably going to be pushed out most of the time, but you will be able to do some cheesy damage to her. You just have to make sure to dodge her spin to win, because then she's going to be healing for more, because she'll be hitting you, and also you'll be taking damage for no reason. But other than that, you just want to clear lanes. There's a very specific way to stack your Q when you go for the Q build. That's why I want to make a Q build video. Again, in teamfight you want to poke, you want to give E as much as possible, and then when it's time to go, you just go and you hit somebody with your auto attack, then you straight away hit your Q, you do that initial burst damage, hopefully you're going to hit two people, which is going to reset your Q if you're going through the Q build. If you're going for a W build, you want to be hitting the front line most of the time, and then just hitting your W on the back line. That's pretty much what you want to be doing. Follow up on any kind of CC, any kind of crowd control from your team. Follow up with your Sulfuras Smash and you should be golden. You can also hit some cheesy, if you predict it right. I wasn't that bad at predicting, but it was sometimes it was bad in this game, my prediction here. But if you predict right, you might be actually, if somebody's escaping or somebody's running in a certain direction, you'll be able to predict where he is 1 second after. And if they're not good at the game or they don't have, you know, good reaction time, they will be hit by that Sulfuras Smash. If you just, let's say for example, Nova is running away from you and you just put it right in front of her, so after that, you know, almost a second, she runs into it and just gets hit by it, potentially taking her out. So again, it's just those things, and again, I'm gonna be going over him again, so hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, well, if you didn't enjoy it, you know what to do, just leave that dislike, tell me what you didn't like. But if you did, leave the like rating, subscribe to the channel, because there's much more coming. I'm actually back from my break now, hopefully. And without further ado, I'll see you guys in the next one.